leaders, what you do is thing to do it for Jesus Christ. Amen. So we thank you, because it takes a lot to step up. A lot to step up into the position. And the position is important, but the mission is always greater. My message is not of my own. It comes from God who sent me. Anyone who wants to do the will of God will know whether my teaching is from God or is merely my own.
Wow. Yes.
Those who speak for themselves want glory only for themselves. But a person who seeks to honor the one who sent him speaks truth, not lies.
Amen.
Father God, we thank you, Lord, for this day, Lord. We thank you, Lord, for this gathering, Lord. We move forward in confidence, Lord. We thank you, Lord, for the joy that you put inside of each and every one of our hearts. Thank you, Lord, for the sacrifice, Lord. It takes sacrifice to be here, Lord. And we make that sacrifice for you, Lord, because we know that it's not in vain, Lord. Lord, you gave me the package, Lord. I'm just the delivery man. I can't wait to pray to you after to just say, mission complete. Thank you, Father. In Jesus' name I pray.
Amen.
I just want to brush up on the word that came out last week, because it builds upon what's happening today. Last week I had the honor to speak about leading with diligence. Leading with diligence requires submission. I'll show you something. Oh yes, we're here to teach.
Do you see any resemblance here, guys?
Yeah.
Leading with diligence requires submission. Well, what does that mean? See, we have the same handwriting too, right, Pastor?
Yes.
Submission means to subtract yourself. And to focus on the mission. Accomplishing a mission requires a team, because we are not here to do this alone. So church, when I say one team, I want to hear y'all say one fight. One team?
One fight.
One team?
One fight.
Woo! All right, you just said we're here together, right? Feeling it. Praise be to God. We also talk about empowerment for purpose. All right, empowerment for purpose. What does that mean? That basically means there's power in the name of Jesus.
Yes.
Amen?
Yes.
Jesus is inside of you, amen?
Amen?
Amen.
Therefore, there is power inside of you.
Amen.
See how that's connected?
Come on, brother.
So though it is written, next slide, my brother. In the book of Luke, chapter 18, verse 27, the things that are impossible with men are possible with God.
That's right.
Next slide. It is also written in the book of John 14, 12, most assuredly I say to you, he who believes in me, the works that I do, he will do also, and greater works than these he will do, because I go to my Father. When he says greater works, he's talking about you. You will do these works.
Yes.
So when I say make the impossible, I want to hear you guys say possible. Make the impossible?
Possible.
Make the impossible?
Possible.
For if God is inside of you, then we can make the impossible possible.
Amen.
We also concluded with the point that we must live in the truth. And that truth is that Jesus is the center of life. Amen?
Yes. Amen.
If you have your notepads, please take it out. And I thank you for your humbleness and humility. And you have this young man teaching all of these. Oh, I stand here confident. Today, I want to tell you that you matter. All of you.
Amen, amen, yes, amen.
Yes. There's a reason you know you need to know this. Because until you know it, until you believe it, and until you can live it, you will never become what you need to become. And you will never do what you are purposed to do. Maybe you never knew how much you matter. Each and every one of you matter. Or no one ever told you that you matter.
Say so.
People will underestimate you. And sometimes, the people that are supposed to be in your support team will be on your hater team.
Amen.
Amen.
But nevertheless, what's inside of you is so great. And when you realize that, you will grow to do what you were born to do. You will grow to do what you were called to do. You have to break the chains of limitation so you can walk in your inspiration. That, and I believe that will lead you to your destination.
Absolutely. Amen. Amen. Amen.
One team?
One.
Oh, you forgot one team?
One.
Woo! Forget, never forget. Inspiration will lead to your destination, okay? Well, let me get church for you, with you for a minute. Brother Michael, what does inspiration have to do with salvation? Well, Pastor, I'm glad that you asked. Nowhere in the Word of God does it say to be saved and just have a nice day. It says to be saved and be the change today. Next slide, please. For it is written in the book of Romans, chapter 12, verse 2, and do not be conformed to this world, but be transformed by the renewing of your mind, that you may prove what is good, acceptable, and perfect will of God. Now, though you hear this verse all the time, I don't bring this up as a cliche. The word of God is not a cliche.
That's right. Amen.
The word of God says be a transformer, right?
Yes.
Be transformed. The mind. Whip your mind right. Transformers. I'll give you transformation thinking. Transformers take the obstacles that come their way and turn them into opportunities. Yes. Amen?
Yes, sir.
Transformers will take stumbling blocks and will turn them into stepping stones.
Yes.
True. Amen.
Transformers will take their haters and will turn them into motivators.
Yes.
Come on. Amen.
Amen.
Yes. Amen. Amen.
Next slide. Know you're a transformer. I'm a transformer. What is inside me is great. Matter of fact, Michael Velazquez transforming. Woo! I'm more than meets the eye. Amen.
Amen.
Don't judge on what you see.
Yeah.
God is inside of me. So whatever he pours in me will be poured out to you.
Amen.
You say that to yourself.
Amen.
You are more than what people see. Just like James.
Amen.
More than what people say.
Amen.
Amen.
Next point that I want to make. It's going to be hard.
Yes, sir.
It's going to
be hard. It's worthwhile.
So with me, make the impossible?
Possible.
Make the impossible?
Possible.
Make the impossible?
Possible.
Make the impossible?
Possible.
Hallelujah. It's going to be hard. You may not have all the resources that you may need to obtain your dream. You may not have had the mentors in your life to help you get where you have to go. I understand. Everything in your life may not be right. May not be right for you. Life is hard. Mm. The people that you love the most will do the worst to you.
Amen.
Anybody relate to that?
Amen.
Okay. It hurts. And sometimes you'll just have nothing left. No more energy. No more power. That's it. Life is rough. And the things that people say hurt. I know it's said that sticks and stones break my bones, but words will never hurt me. But I'm telling you right now, that's a lie.
It's a lie.
Amen.
Just as there is power in the good words they will speak, there's also power in the bad ones too.
Amen.
And if you don't believe me, then you can look at the graves of those who have been bullied and taken their own lives.
Yes.
Yes.
Amen.
Yes.
That's real. This is real. How people look at you, how they respond to you, it's rough. Next slide, please. Life is rough. Life is tough. What? I got some good news. It's worth it. In order for you to get where you have to go, you have to push through everything you've been through and everything that you're going through right now. Amen?
Amen.
So it's going to be hard. Life is hard. So we're going to go harder. Right?
Amen.
We have God with us. We can go harder.
Yeah.
We can go stronger.
Yeah.
We can push it another mile.
Yes.
Word of God says, go one, we'll go two. Because
yes.
We believe in that which He put inside of us.
Yes.
Amen?
Amen.
Woo. So, tough times are going to come. But tough times do not last. It is tough people that do last.
Amen. Amen. Amen.
Now, I'm not saying don't live in love. You have to be tough, right? It's true. We're strong. We're soldiers. We're warriors of God, right? Put on the armor of God. It's all real. I'm not saying don't live in love. You don't have to close out the world to be tough. You don't have to say, I'm going to do it on my own. I don't need nobody else. No, we're not here alone. Even when you meet people that's just angry and to themselves, there's a reason they've become how they've gotten where they've gotten.
Amen. Yes.
I believe behind anger is hurt.
Yes.
So when you see these angry people, you're really seeing people that were hurt.
Yes.
That's the land. If I touch the hot stove, right?
Yes, sir.
And I felt the burn, right?
Yes.
And I'm angry because I got burned, right? Which came first? Me being angry or the hurt that came from the pain?
The hurt came first, right?
Yes,
sir.
Right? Yes. So behind that anger from a divorce, behind that anger from losing your child, behind that anger, behind that hurt, behind it from the people you love just leaving you, there's a reason why people are hurt.
Mm.
But living a life of anger is not the way.
That's right.
Leaving your husband or wife when they've done you no harm is not the way. Living a life of drugs and crime is not the way.
Amen.
Giving up on yourself is not the way.
Amen.
It's hard, but easy is not an option. No one is going to pull a hand out and say, this is your dreams manifested.
Amen.
Take
Amen.
It. You have to work for that. It's your dream. You have to be responsible for it. You have to say to yourself, be determined to say to yourself every day, I can get through this. I will get through this. I was made for this. I must get through this. Repeat
Amen.
After me. I can.
I can.
I will.
I will.
I must.
I must.
I can.
I can.
I will.
I will.
I must.
I must.
Say that to yourself every day.
Amen.
Come on, bro.
It is possible. It is beyond possible. Because you are powerful beyond measure.
Amen.
You can get through this and you will get through this. It is possible, but you must have faith.
Praise God. Amen.
Next slide.
Amen.
And I will, and I must.
Mm.
Next slide, please. Hebrews chapter 11, verse 6. And without faith, it is impossible to please God. Yes, go ahead. Because, right? Yes. Well, Brother Michael, how do you have so much faith? I'm glad that you have. I have so much faith in God because He's did it before.
That's right.
He did it for Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego.
Yes, He did.
Next slide, please.
Yes, He did.
If we move up, we'll be able to press play into video. Please get the lights.
You know how hard I'm calling to seek your presence. When we wish to bend something that is hard and unyielding, what do we do with it? We put it into the fire. Majesty, take it.
Dare you? And we seek your presence.
Burn them.
Majesty, no!
Burn them! What? No! Hey, bring oil!
cannot ignore my tears. I'm overcome by sorrow. I call upon the name of the Lord. Lord, save me! Why do they not burn?
By a motivational speaker, a powerful man. He said, if you can look up, you can get up. So if you're in your circumstance, and if you can look up, you can get through it.
Yeah.
If you're in the problem that you're facing, if your marriage are having some problems, the marriages are going to have problems. If you're at your job, you're at your workplace, which is a place that you can be the change. If you can look up, you can get up and you can get through it. You can make the impossible possible. Make the impossible.
Possible.
Make the impossible.
Possible.
Make the impossible.
Possible.
Make the impossible.
Possible.
Believe it. Believe it,
man.
You must be a survivor. Survivors never quit. Survivors get back up when they fall. Some people are going to tell you that you can't do it. That's all right. But guess what? Other people won't see it. Other people won't believe it inside of you. You're just going to have to endure through it. But trust me, it's worth it. It is worth it. Say it to yourself, it's worth it.
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 In conclusion, if God did it before,
He will do it again.
If God did it before,
He will do it again.
If God did it before,
He will do it again.
Please, we just want to stand up. We finished strong with some praise.
Yeah.
I just want to let you know, you're not in this alone. So if you want to lift your hands,
let's go, guys.
This is perfect. This is, woo! We should be happy to praise the Lord. Yes.
Yeah.
Thank you. and your people know that they will do it. They know that you are inside of us, Lord. And all power, all praises be to you, Lord. But check this out. Lord, I learned this. You're inside of us, so the power is actually inside of us. So we can make the impossible possible. We can accomplish the mission you gave us. We thank you, Lord, for the position, but we know that the mission is greater. We speak with the hearts. We'll make that sacrifice so we can move forth. We hold your word, and we remain tough because we are warriors of God. In Jesus' name, amen.